Hello everyone, in the today session in VB.net we will discuss about for each loop, next, exit and continue statement. In previous session we have discussed about the basics, about class, the hello programs. These things we have discussed in the previous session. Now we will start with this session. About the session, in this session you will learn VB.net for each loop, syntax of the VB.net for each, next statement, how to use for each loop in VB.net, and VB.net exit for and continue for statements. So these things we will cover up in the today session. So let me start with the first things. Now proceed to the next. Syntax of VB.net for each, next statement. The VB.net for each statement takes the syntax given below. See this. For each item, then square brackets as data types, in group, in statements, continue for statements, and exit for and statements, and then next item. So this is the syntax. See this. The item is the variable that will be used to iterate over all items of the collection. The data type is the data type of the element. It is required if the item had not been declared. The group is the collection over which statements are to be repeated. It is required. The statements is optional. It denotes either one or more statements to be executed for every item in the group. The continue for will be transfer control to the begin of for each loop. It is optional. The exit for will transfer control out of for each loop. It is optional. The next mark, the end of for each loop. It is required. So these are the points regarding the syntax. I hope it is clear about the syntax of VB.net for each, next statement. Now proceed to the next. How to use for each loop in VB.net? The following example shows how to use for each loop in VB.net. Step 1. Create a new console application. Begin by creating a new console application. Step 2. Use the following code. Use the following code to learn for each loop in VB.NET. See this module. Name of the module is module 1, sub main. Inside this, you have to declare an array type of integer using dim. Dim my array as integer equal to, we have to initialize the value with 10, 3, 12, 23, 9. Next, dim item as an integer. Now for each loop, we have to use here for each item as variable in my array. So the item variable will retrieve each and every value from my array. Inside this loop, we can display the item using console.writeLine of item. Next keyword, then console.readKey function, then AndSub, and last and module. Step 3. Click the start button. Clicking on the start button from the top bar to run the code, you should get the following result. See this, 10, 3, 12, 23, and 9. So this is the use of for each loop. We can use to retrieve individual value or each value from a collection using item variable. I hope you have to understand about for each loop. Now proceed to the next. About the explanation of the code we have discussed just in previous slide. See, this is your code. Now we have to explain line by line, and it is already marked 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So the explanation of code, first creating a module named module 1, starting the main sub procedure. Next, creating an array named my array with a set of 4 integers. Next, creating an integer variable named item. Using the item variable to iterate over the items of the array named my array. Next, printing the items found in the array by the above statements on the console. Then next, end of the for each loop. Next, pausing the console window for a while, waiting for a user to take action to close the window. Then next, end of the main sub procedure, and last, end of the module. So these are the explanation of the code of each and every line. So I hope it is clear to everyone. Now proceed to the next. VB.NET exit for and continue for statement. When you use the exit for a statement, the execution will leave the for each next loop and control will be transferred to the statements that come after the next statement. When you use the continue for a statement, control will be transferred to the next iteration of your loop. Let's demonstrate this using an example. Step 1. Begin by creating a new console application. Step 2. Use the following code. See this. Module 1, sub main processor, then nums as an integer, set of values are there, then for each loop, for each and as an integer in nums inside the loop. If n is greater than equal to 17, and n is less than equal to 25, then continue for, and if console.write inside and dot to string ampersand and double quotes space, if n equal to 37, then exit for, and if next console dot read key function and sub and module. This is the code example. Step 3. Run the code by clicking the start button from the top bar. You should get the following result. See this. Stain 12, 14, 26, 31, 33, 37. This is the output of the code. Now let me explain each or every line of the code on the next slide. So now move to the next explanation of the code. This is your example. And we have to mark off each and every line, like 1, 2, 3. So now explain this. First, creating a module named module 1. Next, starting the main sub processor. Next, creating an array named nums with a set of integers. Next, creating a variable named n, then we use it to iterate over the elements. contained in the array nums. Next, using an if then condition to check the value of the variable n. If the value is between 17, which is included, and 25, also included, the iteration will skip to the next item in the array. Next, the skipping of the above values is done here. This is the statement necessary for performing the skip. Next, and the if condition. Next, printing the values obtained from the array on the console. The toString function helps us convert the values from numbers to strings. Next, checking the iteration variable n for the when its value is 37 using an if then condition. Next, exiting the for each loop when the above condition is true, that's the value of n equal to 37. Next, and of the above if condition. Next, and of the for each statement. Then pause the console window waiting for the user to take action to close it. Next, and of the main sub procedure, and last, and of the module. So these are the explanation of each and every line of the example. I hope it's clearly understood of each and every line about the example. This is all about for the today's session. Thank you, all of you.